This video is in response to one of the queries I received from a young girl seeking advice on how can girls or women ensure that they have lasting careers and they can really unleash their potential and move up the corporate ladder. It's also a topic that's very close to my heart. It's not unachievable. However, the harsh reality remains that 60 to 80% of girls or women, depending on demographics, location, etc., drop out of work either post-marriage or after having a child. If you prepare yourself early on in your life, maybe when you are in your early 20s, mentally, physically and emotionally, you make the right decisions and invest in yourself, I do believe a woman can enjoy being a mother, being a wife and having a fulfilling career. Today's session I really want to dedicate to the girls who are still in their early 20s, maybe up to mid 20s, because that's when you're laying the foundation for a very fulfilling life, including a career. There are a few things that one can reflect upon, and I will talk upon these to have a good start, to make sure as they develop, as they grow, they're moving in the right direction. First one, and I say this very often, is networking. It's very important for women to network, not just with girls and women, but also with the men around them. Their social circle should include a healthy mix of women and men who are in their ancillary fields of the career choices that they've made or in the fields that they are working in the sectors that they are working in. And when you're socializing, it shouldn't be just about events or entertainment. You should be trying to figure out how are they thinking, what are they thinking of investing in as a career choice, as a training, as a skill, whom are they networking with, learn and reapply. And that's a factor, that's something you should be doing throughout your life, talking to people, picking up what makes sense for you, learning and reapplying that. This is also a time, if you're still on campus or still in your early 20s, you should try and take on extra courses and use them practically to see how much you can apply, build extra skills, so that when you go for your first job interview, you are able to get screened by some good companies which really, really value what a woman brings to the table. The stronger your profile is going to be, the higher the chances that you will land up with a good employer that values gender diversity. Now, early 20s is also a time when you should start investing and get very aware about physical fitness. A healthy body has a healthy mind. For women, it's very, very important to be physically fit, have a lot of energy around them, to be able to multitask and do whatever they have to strike a balance between their careers and their work. Start exercising, whether it's yoga, whether it's cycling, swimming, walking or going to the gym. Whatever you enjoy doing, start doing it now. Even a sport, even like tennis or badminton. But make sure you're spending 40 to 50 minutes every day just on physical fitness. A few more soft skills that I'll talk about. Firstly, your body image and how you dress. Remember, when you walk into a room, people should be looking at what does she bring to the table, of what you talk, what value you bring in. What you wear is secondary. How you look like should be secondary. It should be something that keeps you comfortable, helps you blend into the team, not something that you stand out for. I'm not saying to start dressing up like men. I'm saying wear comfortable clothes that let you be yourself, right? That do not draw attraction or do not draw attention for the wrong reasons. Now, I said you should be known for the value that you bring to the table. That's not going to happen only if you are very internally focused or focused on skill upgrades in your chosen career. You have to be broad-based, and that happens when you read. You read diverse journals, you read newspaper or even online you read, or you listen to YouTube on topics of your interest that add to the content that you carry. I know most girls of that age, and even I do that sometimes, but that should only be sometimes when you pick up a Cosmo or a Stardust or a Vogue, just to browse through and pick up some quick trends. most of the time you should be reading the hard stuff that makes you think and reflect upon and keep improving yourself. Either in the field of management, newspaper is an absolute must. Stay externally focused. I talked about a healthy body and a healthy mind. It's also very important for a long-term fulfilling life to be emotionally very strong. Being emotionally strong requires you to be happy and content with yourself. While we are all social beings, it's really important that you pick up a passion that keeps you engaged and happy should you be alone. There are going to be several situations in life. There are going to be requirements if you are working alone somewhere where you might feel lonely. That time, you shouldn't get depressed and let that affect your work or your health negatively. You know, a passion could be anything. It could be spending time in an orphanage. It could be singing. It could be dancing. It could be writing blogs, just listening or playing music. Whatever keeps you truly engaged so that you don't feel that loneliness and you're not simply reaching out for company or ending up in the wrong company because you're alone. Lastly, I'll talk about dating and companionship. Early 20s is the time when you are dating. Do a check. How much time do you spend simply going out or spending time watching movies with your date? You know, I would say at your age, out of the dispensable time you have outside college or your first job, probably 80% of the time should be going on making you stronger as a person. Personal fitness, learning, working on yourself. Don't let dating distract you. That person might not be around forever. Don't let yourself lean on someone else too much. If you are lucky enough and you found your life companion, that's very nice. This is not the time to already start making compromises. There'll be a lot of situations later in life where you and your companion will have to make compromises to continue to be together. At this time, you should be bold and have very honest, frank conversations. I'll end by saying time doesn't come back. The early 20s are the time where you have to invest in yourself. Make yourself really strong for the years that are going to come ahead. Use your time wisely. All the best. If you have further queries, drop them in the comment box or email me at prisha.corporatediaries@gmail.com. All the best once again.